Dreamer in the Innovations. Today we are going to see about F450 quadcopter. So this quadcopter is already assembled for one of our client. So I just going to explain about this quadcopter, what are the parts in this quadcopter and also what are the procedure to assemble and to calibrate and to use this quadcopter. So first of all, I just go through the quadcopter parts one by one. You can see the quadcopter parts here. So these are the entire quadcopter parts. So initially, this is the KK board. So this KK board is used for controlling the entire system, that is a flying system. So this flying system is controlled by using this KK board. This is a controller board. This is a controller board that controls the motors via ESC. So this coreless motors are controlled by using the ESC, electronic speed controller, and this electronic speed control is driven by controller board, that is KK board that we are using in this flying part. And this is the receiver board. So receiver board is used for getting the signal from the transmitter. Transmitter will be in the user end. So receiver will be in the flying end. So this is the receiver and this is the transmitter. The transmitter that we are using here is the general purpose transmitter, that is FSCT6B. So this transmitter and receiver can be used for any other robotic projects, and here we are used for controlling the quadcopter. So this transmitter has the throttle, elevator, elevation for controlling the elevation, for controlling the throttle, so for controlling the attitude of the flying part, we are using this transmitters. And also you can see there is a buzzer. So this buzzer indicates when there is a low voltage is found. So by using that, we can safely land the quadcopter to the place. And the battery that we are going to use for this quadcopter is this 35C 3 cell lipo battery. So as you can see, this is 2200 mAh. So we are going to use this battery for this quadcopter. This battery is sufficient for run the quadcopter for 30 minutes. So for calibrating the transmitter, there is a PS2 cable. So by using this cable, we can connect the transmitter to the system, and by using the T-config software, we can calibrate the transmitter to operate the receiver. And this transmitter is powered by 8 AA batteries. And this transmitter is powered by 8 AA batteries. Either we can use 8 AA battery or we can use 12-volt adapter. So this transmitter is powered by 8 AA batteries. So 8 into 1.5, that is nothing but a 12-volt. Or you can also directly use a 12-volt adapter to save the battery during testing purpose. And the quadcopter battery can be charged, recharged by using the compact charger. So this is the charger that we are going to use for recharging the quadcopter battery, and quadcopter battery is directly connected to this charger so that the battery will get charged. I will show you a demo. So you need to connect the battery charger. So battery charger will be connected here. So as you can see, so this is the socket, and we can connect the battery charger like this. So after connecting the battery charger, I just switching on the power supply. So after switching on the power supply, you can see, so all the three LEDs resembles the 3 cell, because this battery has a 3 cell. So all the 3 LEDs resembles the 3 cells. Each cell is in red color, indicates battery yet to be charged. After completely charging, this LED color will turn into green color. So these are the propellers. So this is a propeller. So since I have not connected the propeller to the motors, these propellers will be connected to the motor. So these propellers will be connected to the motors here. So for lifting, so for testing purpose, I just don't want to lift the quadcopter flying part. So I just not connected the propellers. So while coming to the KK board, so I just operate the KK board and show you. So for that, for operating the KK board, I just going to connect the battery. So first of all, you have to, after getting fully charged, you can use the battery for flying. and right now I'm just going to, for testing the purpose, I'm just going to connect the battery here. So I'm just going to connect the battery. So for connecting the battery, you just need to connect like this. So you have to see the flat end and the horizontal end and connect the battery like this. So battery is connected. So now the battery is connected to the quadcopter, and you can see in the display the menus. So I'm just going to reset the quadcopter. For resetting the quadcopter, the battery, there is no need of removing the battery. You can also remove the first wire, that is the first ESC wire, and you can power off the quadcopter. So battery connected to the PCB is given power to all the ESC, and from the ESC the power is given to the KK controller board. So the battery power is directly given to the motors, and from the motors via ESC it is given to the KK power board. So the first wire in the KK power board is responsible for the power of the quadcopter. So by removing the first wire of the KK board, you can power off the quadcopter. So I'm just going to show in close. So as you can see, so I'm just removing the first wire, and you can see the power is turned off. And again I am connecting that first wire, and you can see the power is turned on. So by removing the first wire of the KK board, you can power off the quadcopter. And then I am just showing you in the menus. So menu is not visible clearly. So here you can see the transmitter. So transmitter, I am just switching on the transmitter. So transmitter is switched on, and here you can see the green color LED. So this LED indicates there is a power, sufficient power in the transmitter. So if this LED turns into orange, the power is low. If it is turned to the red, the power is very low. Okay, so now I am just going to test the quadcopter. For testing the quadcopter, so I am just going to repower, because now only the transmitter is turned on. So after turning on the transmitter, I just want to test the receiver. So I am just repowering. For repowering, I just need to remove the power. I am just removing the power and reconnecting the power, and you can see it is turned on in the safe mode. So after turning on in the safe mode, I'm just going to arm the quadcopter. For arming the quadcopter, this throttle will be moved to the right end corner. So this throttle will be moved to the right end corner and left hand corner. So right hand corner will arm the quadcopter and left hand corner will disarm the quadcopter. But you can see in the display actually. So for seeing the display, I'm just trying to show you the display. Okay, so I'm just showing the display. So you can see the display here. So I am just showing you in the display. I am getting into the menu. So these are the menu items. So you can see PI editor, receiver test, everything in the menu item. I'm just pressing the receiver test and getting to the enter mode, and you can see there is the elevator throttle control. I'm just moving the elevator front and back here, and while moving the elevator front and back here, I can see the forward, reverse, back, left, right. So accordingly how we control here, you can see how the signal is connected through the channel of the receiver. And I can also see
the movement here, and again I can also see the throttle. So this is the throttle. So I'm just moving the throttle here. So by moving the throttle, I can see the throttle is getting increased, decreased, and I can see it is in the safe zone, and also it is in the disarm and arm condition. So I just want to arm the quadcopter. So just getting back to the safe, and I'm trying to arm the quadcopter. Now the quadcopter is armed.
Okay, now the quadcopter is armed. I'm just trying to run the motor. For running the motor, I'm just moving the throttle. So if I move the throttle, you can see the motor is running. If I move the throttle, you can see the motor is running. I'm just increasing the speed. So this is the increasing and decreasing the speed. I'm just increasing the speed of the throttle, and you can see the speed of the motor rises. If there is a propeller is connected to the system, right now the quadcopter will be flying. Since propeller is not connected to the system, the quadcopter is not flying. So you can see how fast the motor is rotating. I'm just decreasing the throttle. So you can see how it is rotating. So while rotating the motors, that you should be careful, the ESC should be connected in such a way that the quadcopter will follow the CW, then CCW, and then again CW, and again CCW. The direction of the motors will be in the opposite. The direction of the adjacent motors will be in the opposite. That is, this is if it is in CW, the adjacent will be in CCW, and again this is in CW and adjacent will be in CCW. So for turning the motor CW and CCW, all you have to do is you just have to inverse the wire. So this is the wires. There are three wires. So leaving the black, the yellow and red should be inversed for changing the polarity of the motor. So right now the motor. So right now the quadcopter is in armed condition. So by armed condition, we can fly the quadcopter actually when the propeller is connected. So just I am going to disarm the quadcopter. For disarming the quadcopter, I want to move the throttler to the rightmost position. So if you move the throttler to the rightmost position, the quadcopter will be disarmed. If you move the throttler to the leftmost position, the quadcopter will be armed. So as you can see, I have moved the throttle to the leftmost position. The quadcopter is armed. I am moving the throttle to the rightmost position. So it is disarmed. So similarly, you can control the quadcopter. So when we go to the menu, when we go to the menu, so there are, you can see the PI editor. So this is the PI editor. So PI editor, we have to adjust the gain and limit of the all the parameter like aileron, elevator, rudder. So by adjusting this, we can calibrate the quadcopter, and after that there is the receiver test. So receiver test, and after that, so there is a receiver test. So receiver test will show you the transmitter and receiver connectivity. So after that there is a mode settings. So mode settings will show you the mode, auxiliary mode, and what are the other parameters. And one more important thing you have to see is layout. What is the layout that we are going to use? So the layout that we are going to use, the motor layout that we are going to use, we can see here by using the show motor layout. So this is the motor layout we are using. So motor 1 clockwise, motor 2 anti-clockwise, motor 3 clockwise, and motor 4 anti-clockwise. So other settings are calibration. There are other calibration settings, like there is accelerometer calibration. By using the accelerometer calibration, you can calibrate the accelerometer for the current flat position. And also you can have the sensor test. By pressing the sensor test, you can see what are the sensors and how it is working. So gyro is working fine, accelerometer is working fine. So all these settings are given inside the KK board controller. By using these settings, the quadcopter will be calibrated properly for proper run.
So this values and settings is tuned accordingly so that the quadcopter will fly smoothly. So based on the settings, the quadcopter fly will be decided. So this is the transmitter. So from the transmitter, the receiver. So this is the receiver. Receiver will receive the signal and control the entire system. So this is how the F450 quadcopter is assembled and calibrated and tested. I have not given all the clear picture, but anyway you can have an idea how the quadcopter is functioning, what are the parts of quadcopter, so how the settings in the quadcopter. Thank you.